Now we have something. Now we definitely have something in this community replay being submitted by Mr. Akitas. Not as the Greenskins today, but going as the Vampire Counts with a very, very, very girthy lineup. Lots of zombies in the front line, a shit ton of spearmen and even skeleton warriors, and some heavy hidden graveguard with great weapons, plus a couple of cryptors to give a little bit more of infantry support, and some very efficacious black knights with lances and bardings, and even some direwolves flying around here too. Now, the Greenskins already getting off to a very early skirmish attack as they get all of their goblin riders out over here and harassing the edges and the flanks of these vampire counts. They really don't have a good way to respond to such things, but the good news is that once they actually do meet those lines, the vampire counts got a lot of killing tools here, but unfortunately, yeah, they really don't have a great way to actually get these guys off their bat. The best thing for the vampire counts right here is just the fact that these skirmish units don't really have that much killing power, so I think they'll just have to eat up the early game woes of this one and continue the march forwards as they do get some of their Black Knights in motion here. They're going to try to go for a charge. I don't know if they'll be able to catch them. They do have 72 speed versus the 92 speed of the Goblins, which will certainly not be able to catch up to them unless they make some sort of grave mistake. Maybe if the doggies can get on them first, which actually they will. Holy shit, those dogs are fast AF. Nope, they're going to stop. Oh no, a missed opportunity right there as they could have maybe gotten down one of those units. And now they will actually retreat a little bit, setting up a nice line, getting ready for the Greenskins infantry attack. This game is great so far, Akitas. Oh my god, man, I absolutely love it. The early game skirmish, plus the setting up of the infantry lines. Oh, it is beautiful. It is really a thing of beauty right here as we get a nice breath spell by this White King, who will shave off a few numbers of those Savage Orcs. Kind of a scary unit for these Vampire Counts to deal with, however. They do still have both of their cav units, and of course their very, very powerful graveguard with great weapons, but they don't really have a great unit to use it on. Maybe the stone trolls kinda, as they are armored, but everything else on this lineup here is not really packing too heavy of armor. And now Mr. Blood Dragon Vampire Lord will land down in on this massive troops and get to work on both the stone trolls plus the Savage Orcs, which there are just so many of these Savage Orcs, like that's actually really scary as they continue to move on. Actually, even on the left-hand flank, breaking through and breaking off some of these cryptors, not breaking them off, obviously, but they just had to retreat, as I don't think they like that encounter. The Skeleton Spearmen over here not going to be able to go toe-to-toe with these Savage Orcs, but when they have the support of these cryptors, I think they might even be able to fend them off, at least for now, hold them down, and the Blood Dragon Vampire Lord doing his thing, keeping everyone nice and safu over here as they go toe-to-toe, Lord versus Lord, Wurzog versus Blood Dragon Vampire Lord, and a lot of infantry in between, getting their weapons wet, if you will, as the Stone Troll is actually doing a big amount of damage, like really chewing through 73 kills on that unit's to that unit's name, and some Graveguard over here actually having no problem with these Savage Orcs, as you would guess. On the other end, though, Direwolves gonna fight it out to the last wolfie here as all of the skirmish cav converges on them and now goes back into firing on the Blood Dragon Vampire Lord on his massive dragon, of course. Anyways, with that in mind, the two White Kings over here. Very, very staunch, very difficult for the enemies to take down, and more importantly, they're just occupying these Savage Orc Biggins, which allows everyone else to kind of do their thing and not have to take all that much damage, because the White King's actually not really taking much themselves. In fact, actually looking pretty good there, if anything. But where is Wurzog? There is Wurzog. I found you, Wurzog. What are you doing, Wurzog? What are you doing over there? Well, you're actually doing not much. I'm guessing he's setting up to do a bit of casting and a massive wind spell. Oh my god, two wind spells going down each ways here. Not that effective on these Goblin Wolf Rider archers, but looks pretty damn cool nonetheless. That was just a thing of beauty, as you do see the left flank now really collapse in favor of the Vampire Counts. So good job over there. The Knights are getting their, the Cavalry units getting some absolutely glorious charges into the infantry lines over there, and then obviously locking down Mr. Wurzog himself. But at this point, the Blood Dragon Vampire Lord taking a lot of damage. Now, of course, he can heal a bit, but he obviously doesn't want to go down. I mean, if he goes down, then that's pretty much game over for the Vampire Counts. So hopefully he can get back. to a safe distance and heal up a bit, because Warzog is a very, 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 very powerful caster. But here goes the infantry units for the Greenskins. They are breaking away. Lots of units leaving the battlefield right now, and the last of the Stone Trolls is even starting to waver as they can't go toe-to-toe with the Great Weapons Graveguard. And now the infantry of the Vampire Counts really taking over the field, and while a lot of these Greenskin units will come back, they're really beat up now, and their leadership is just not having a good time. Plus, Warzog, where is he? Yep, he's right over here. He's actually still very healthy, and he's going to go directly toe-to-toe. Oh my god, he's going to go with the Blood Dragon Vampire Lord, who will get a heal off. Nice. All right. Let's see what he can do from there, shattering one of the Savage Orc units, and now turning his talons towards Warzog, who is going to be taking a lot of damage off just a couple swipes there, but so is the Blood Dragon Vampire Lord, getting all of the girth of these skirmish cav over here, firing at him at the same time. He does still have maybe another heal left in his back pocket, but Jesus Christ, man, his health is getting dangerously low here. The knights will get around Warzog himself, both taking a lot of damage, but the Blood Dragon Vampire Lord is forced to leave, throwing down another wind spell on all of those skirmish cav, and Warzog is going to take a breast belt to the face, and holy shit, he's starting to waver. Oh, the two Whitekins are right on him, and he'll land down in for the kill. Oh, it's a thing of fucking beauty. It is a thing of motherfucking beauty. Holy shit, Akitas. Wow. Oh my god. I love watching Akitas' game. He's just so fucking good. He's so fucking good at this game. It's ridiculous. Beautiful play right there. And a lot of the Greenskins will start to break and shatter off, as you would suspect, as their leader gets killed off. Even the Vampire Counts not having the best time after that as well, but they're going to hold in there a little bit better than the Greenskins, of course, and all they need to do is just make sure that those infantry units do not come back, and the Cryptors and the Graveguard should be able to finish the job. The Skirmish Cav over here will certainly not be able to do anything much more than just a annoying poke from afar into them. But can they maybe get them into crumbling mode? Probably not. No, I don't think so. And those White Kings are a little bit too staunch, I think, for them to do much of any concerning damage, really. So they will swing back around. They do have one unit of Broken Tusk Mob, which is actually a pretty damn strong unit, to be fair. But they got a little bit too much to deal with here, as the Cryptors actually start to disintegrate themselves, or sorry, crumble themselves. Not looking the best, but even the one semi-alive unit of Black Knights is going to be able to fend off the charges of these Goblin Wolf Rider archers. So at least they have a bit of defense for that. And the last of the Mogrib's Mungies get forced off there too. Although they're actually still relatively healthy, but that's not the point at this point. The point is that they really don't have a good... I don't see that they have any tools to take down these guys over here. That's the problem. The Graveguard actually are starting to really take a lot of leadership damage there. As you can see, they have critical binding. Not the best right now, but in a game of attrition, I always give the nod to the Vampire Counts. They are just built for such things, and while these guys over here will crumble into the ground, they will not stay around for forever, even getting fired upon by that unit over there too. They'll waste a little bit more of their arrows, and more importantly, this mass of troops over here just slowly edges their way towards the last of the Savage Orcs, and these and of course the Broken Tusk Mob as well. Little bit of a scary unit here, but the Graveguard with great weapons will be able to lock them down. Here comes the Cryptors. If they can just take them down, they should be okay. And they actually are already really, really beat up there, wavering now, and certainly not going to be staying around for too much longer. And if they do get another charge, then they probably will just break off of that, as the Knights, the Black Knights over here, forced off themselves, but not before shattering two units of Savage Orcs, one of them being a Biggins unit as well. And I think that the leadership penalties for the Greenskins are really coming home to roost here, and it is just not the time for that. And there it is, the Pyrrhic victory awarded to Mr. Akitas. Wow, man, I have to tell you, I've certainly lost my love of the Warhammer Total War series for now, but my god, man, watching those matches are just fucking great. Credit to Mr. Akitas. I'll see you in the next one. Take care.